Never, for the sake of peace and quiet, deny your own experience or convictions. Hi, I'm Linda Watson Kong. Thank you for joining this episode of Dragonfly Soup. Did you ever want to say something but thought, no, I better not? Well, yeah, the striped shirt she's wearing really clashes with those plaid pants, but who am I to tell her how to dress? Good choice not mentioning it. Maybe she was in a hurry and didn't notice the shirt. Or maybe everything was in the wash and this was the only clean clothes in the closet. Regardless of the circumstances, you chose not to say anything about it. But what about the time you wanted to speak up at a meeting and explain that the information being presented wasn't 100% accurate? And a decision based on this incorrect information could make matters worse in the long run. But you knew the people in the meeting. You knew that if you said something about their information, a lot of people would get upset. So instead of saying anything, you just sat there quietly. Maybe you even decided to leave and not deal with it at all. And do you remember the time you felt confident that you had a great idea for a new business? No, something like this had never been done before, but you wanted to give it a try. You were told by some people you trusted that it was a foolish idea and it would never work. Situations like this happen every day and everywhere, and to a lot of people. The answer isn't in what has happened. It is, however, in the response. Dag Hammarskjöld, an economist and diplomat who also served as the Secretary General of the United Nations, once said, "Never, for the sake of peace and quiet, deny your own experience or convictions." Speaking up when you know something is wrong can be very hard. Sometimes you even doubt yourself. Okay, what if my information isn't correct? But what if it is? Double check it. Make sure that you have the facts right. If everything lines up, then your information is correct. Oh, but what if I speak up and no one believes me? Well, you did what you had to do, and the rest is on them. At least you did your part. But what if I lose my friends or worse? Yes, things could turn pretty ugly, or things could turn out okay. Did you ever see the movie Silkwood? Now, most of us will never hold the title of a whistleblower like Karen Silkwood did, but if she hadn't spoken up, if she hadn't presented the facts as she knew them to the authorities, more people's lives would have been endangered. When Karen discovered that she was exposed to radiation, she fought hard for safer working conditions in the nuclear plant where she and her boyfriend had worked. Better safety practices were finally put in place, but it didn't happen without a battle. She knew what she had experienced and was determined to prevent this from happening to others. Now here's another example. Have you heard of La Tote? Sounds like some sort of a purse or bag, doesn't it? Well, La Tote is a relatively new company. It was started in 2012 by two friends. They came up with the idea to rent clothes. Now, there was one company at that time that sold clothing subscriptions. Now, I'm not sure how that worked. But there was another company that rented special occasion clothing. You know, the type you would probably wear only once to some formal event. And I've got some of those clothing in my closet right now. But no one rented regular, everyday clothes. You know, sweatshirts, leggings, jackets. Wear them and return them. But if you really like them, you would have the option to buy them. Everyone told these two friends that they were crazy. They would never make it by offering the convenience of ordering online with the ease of returning them. Yep, they even provided the return package, no postage needed. Were they crazy? Not at all. They were so successful that they just bought Lord & Taylor, so customers who enjoyed going to a store could make their rental selections that way as well. They would have never enjoyed the success if they hadn't held on to their convictions. They felt ever so strongly that this is something that people want. So, how about you? It's time we look at and reevaluate our goals. It's time we look at what we want to do and accomplish. Now, let's say you enjoy the experience of using essential oils. You want to set up a small store selling and teaching people the benefits of the oils. Your family and friends tell you there are better businesses to get into if you want to own a store. Do you listen to them just to keep everything peaceful? Or do you say, thank you for your advice, but I'd like to try this idea anyway? Do you have the belief in yourself that you can create that business and succeed? Remember, when people offer you their opinion on your life, they're really telling you what is true for their life. If they haven't tried it, how could they possibly know that it can't be done? And here's the newsflash. If that person was there or is there starting a new business, he or she would probably offer you suggestions on how you can make your idea a success rather than tell you not to do it. So take your dreams, your goals, and act on them. Discuss them with people who are supportive and offer encouragement. Take the necessary steps to achieve the success that you know is yours. And tell me, either in a personal message or an email, what steps you plan to take this week. Be sure to click like and share this episode with a friend. You might also want to check out our gift shop, where you can purchase items like Dragonfly Soup t-shirts, hoodies, or other gifts. The link is below. Or you can show your support for this program by clicking this link. Any contribution to help continue this series is greatly appreciated. And I'll see you next week, right here on Dragonfly Soup. Here's to our transformation and our best year ever.